So you're seeing right now yung DevFest 2018 na site repository for this one, and I'm currently for this one I'm doing yung create speaker list component. So as you can see here, it is number 31. Pag tinignan natin yung issue, it's yung number 31 na list. So ganito yung ating setup lagi. We'll have to check kung ano yung issue na kailangang magawa. And yan. So we should create yung speaker list page UI. So let's go over yung code itself, and npm start tayo. So that's how we run yung project dito sa ano. Oops, wait lang, may lamok. Ayan, okay, never mind. Wala na siya. Now, let's go over saan. Nasa git. Check out. Ano ulit yun? Yung branch itself. It's create secret list 31. So, yan siya. Now, it should work. Yep. And we should see sa page home. I already started doing it actually. And nadagdag yung part after ito. Ito yung dinagdag ko. So I created the speaker section. So just to show you kung ano yung itsura niya when ano. We'll look at this. Wait lang. So ito yung itsura niya. Siya. Excuse, you can see. Ayan, let's make it as a ngayon muna siya. So this is yung it's a component, it's a reusable component based sa idea na let's see. Dito nga ba yun? Based on the idea na nahanap ko lang yung picture na dapat gawan or pagbasihan nito. Aha, ang tagal ko siyang hanapin. Wait lang. Okay. Okay. So, yung talagang pagbabasihan natin is this one. Which ang tagal lang i-load. Yan. So ito yung idea. Tagal yung bagal yung pag load itself. Okay. Bagal lang yung rendering. Okay. So ganito yung gustong nating mangyari. Although wala pa tayo nitong mga parts na to. And ito yung nagawa na natin, which is ganyan. Now, on our code, as we can see, pag chinek natin to, it's actually just a tag. And yung sumunod na is yung section at yung section sa taas. Now, why did I created this? Because I plan it to have like a speaker page itself na ang laman lang niya is itong section na to. So, instead of like coding it again on like kukode ko ulit itong part na to, I could just create na itong section lang, which is I can put it on the page. And that goes dun sa ating first rule natin for this project, is that the page itself, as you can see, itong page home is just except for the by part, which I use for tracking kung sino or kung ilan na yung mapumindot ng buy button na yun or if it's useful. It should only be this one. You only need yung template and then that's already enough. So if in essence, kunyari, copy ko to and then paste, I create a page na, let's say, speakers. Create a page na for speakers lang and then just change this. At ang kailangan ko lang ay wala akong lazy picture. I just need yung so hindi ko na to kailangan. Hindi ko to kailangan din if ano. Hindi ko rin to kailangan tong banner na to. At itong nasa baba. At saka yung what to expect. And thank you to our sponsors. So, once I've saved that, and change yung front end natin to have yung speaker. That's stupid of me. And then I wanted to have it na parang change yung yan to this one. Now I just have to reset yung server. And lastly, I go sa components, sa navigation. Oops, not the smart components, navigation loader, to add let's say I wanted to have a home. Oops, not that one. I want to have na home. And speakers, which goes din sa speakers part. Once na bumalik tayo dito, we have here home and speakers, as you can see dito sa code ko na I just added yung navigation. And dito siya, pag pinindot ko to, it shows na yung speaker list, which in essence I could also add an additional style in such a way na, oops, alisin natin to kasi this is not needed anymore for the speakers. We just want to have, let's say, yung which pag tinignan natin, ano ulit yun? Speaker section. Wanted to have yung speaker section to have a padding top of, let's say, 100px, and then 0, 0 for top and bottom. And voila, so let's have it on 120 para meron siya, meron tayong ganyan. Pwede rin natin gawin ng ano, lagyan ng bottom itself. And we also have, we can now use yung ano, yung pagkat pinindot natin yung home, we have yung speakers, which is nice. You can also edit yung speakers. You can also edit yung speakers dun sa kanyang component, which is yung speaker section. Yung kanyang style, you can have like, not the speaker section, but itong container. So as you can see, it's actually a container with the speaker's title, which is this one, yung kanina, ito. And then we have the slot, which holds yung loader. As you can see dito sa home, meron tayong speaker list loader at speaker list itself. So ito yung tinatawag nating section container natin na that is reusable. And ito yung data loader natin, aka smart component. So we want to have yung smart component kasi we separate yung loader natin with the data container. So parang ito yung data container naman, or which shows how data should be visualized, aka dump component. So yeah. And we can see this in our way yung itong pattern na to on other parts. So like in essence, in the project header, you can also see na meron akong navigation loader and yung header navigation. On the sidebar, we also have a navigation and a sidebar. So as you can see, I'm using the same navigation loader, which is yung kanina nating sinet, itong this set navigation. And ang ginagawa lang niya is from that connected callback, it sets yung navigation itself, which is this one. Itong pinasok natin will be fed on either a side navigation or a header navigation. For a header navigation, as you can see, pinapasok lang niya as a navigation. Now, itong code na to, you can see it in lit HTML. In essence, you can just go and find documentation on lit HTML on how to use talaga. On, like, kunyari ito, itong navigation part na to is actually a for loop for showing itong template na to as part of the navigation list. So pag tiningnan natin yung code itself dun sa taas, yan, meron tayong dalawang home speakers, dalawang links pala. You can see ito yung navigation loader, we have it the header navigation, and then you have your navigation list, AUL, and two LIs. Diba? So, two LIs, which is, in essence, tignan natin yung code. Ito yung two LIs na navigation, just because on setting the navigation here, which is dalawang items, we have set it na ganito. We put the navigation, the value of that, the array itself, as the property. And pag tinignan natin ulit yung header navigation, when the property navigation is set, we add yung request render. So yeah, anyway, now that has been sort of settled, we now figure kung paano i-load yung tamang items. So let's just add something else dun sa speaker section. Na let's say magdagdag ako ng padding bottom na 120px, I guess, just to show na or na. So ito yung una niya. Yan, and I guess I better na 24px lang to, I guess. Yeah, pwede na yata yung ganyan. As you can see, images are loaded a bit slow, maybe because of my internet connection. But yun nga. So now, how does yung information nito work? As you can see, di ba meron nga tayong idea nito is wanted to have the loader puts the data on the speaker list. So pag tingnan natin yung loader, speaker loader, which is here, we have we should be using Firebase, but for now I created parang a dummy data, which you can actually, in essence, instead of parang kailangan natin ng i-connect na agad sa database, which we're going to use Firebase in a bit. Instead of doing that, we can already put in our data here. So let's just say, sabi natin, dagdag ako ng 4 pa. Dagdag ako ng 4 pa. And pag tinignan natin ito, I refresh. Oops. Nag-apat na sila. Now, we can see na, oops, parang hindi yata maganda. So, we'll edit yung speaker list. Speaker list. Yung speaker list is, you can see na ito lang siya. It's a grid. We wrap it on a grid na merong summary items. Actually, we can already change this to this one. And instead of adding like an extra div here, we use the container itself as this one. And it will garner the same sort of results. Now, as you can see, parang ang weird nito. But, pag tinignan natin, the reason for this one is that the length of the speaker summary item is, or the width is actually 107. And pag binalikan natin yung code natin, yung style natin, ang minimum is 100. So if we, let's say, add it as 250px, we get this result. Na on a screen na 1440, we have this but on a larger screen, like let's say 2560, we have 5. If we have like let's say on 9 guess. So it's still big. So that means on our screen we can have like siguro 300px and it will autofill or auto fit. So apat, which in essence kung titingnan natin yung ating original idea, original design, ay apat lang talaga yung for this large screen. It's already good. Now, can still add some things, I guess. Here, sa isang component, you have your index. Pag dump component siya, which is itong speaker list, we can state, we can use yung property slide to be able to use this, and yung template slide to be able to use yung pag-render and yung template. So this one is part ng template light, and this one is part also still part ng template light, while this one is part ng property slide. Oops, my mouse is not working. Yeah. So the idea is binoilerplate ko na yung part na or binoilerplate part na ng boilerplate code na yung properties parang hide away yung paggawa ng setter and getter as example ng header navigation, which is this one. So ito is hidden away na, instead of like doing this and then calling the request render para mag-render siya if there's changes in navigation. Instead of doing that, ganito na lang, and that's already hindi mo na kailangan isipin. And then you can also add like a default value for the properties. Now, pagdating sa template, you can see here, ito lang yung kailangan. No need for additional stuff. Now, in essence, tapos na nga natin itong part na to, but we need to add the data, which for now gagawin ko siya later on siguro on one of my coding sessions. I'll just have to install OBS also on my laptop, but in essence ganun yung kailangan natin gawin. Now after that, so let's say add speaker page dito, then we can add a PR later on dito. So we'll just do that in a bit. Hopefully it gets you something to think about on how the system works. I know it's a bit magulo kasi kulang pa rin ako sa tulog. Dapat ginawa ko to kagabi, but I'm still working on a proper way of introducing this project. If you want to, if you have questions on like saan pwede magsimula or ano dapat yung kailangan yung malaman, please ask so that I can properly manage it in essence, or teach it in essence. But I've put in a little bit of documentation on this. I'm planning to have na yung proper documentation on element light, which is you can see dito. Actually it's element light, but it's on create modulized version. Hindi ko pa siya na, oops, meron akong vulnerable dependency, but you can see yung array accessors, object accessors, service light, excuse me, and properties light. You can you can also see yung slides about it. Sa slides ko, which is where is that? Wait lang. So which is here. Can see yung parang idea nito nung element light dito sa part na to. At ito yung parang in essence dependencies. Oh no no no, this is polymer, but ito yung sa element light. That means if you want to have properties, you use properties light. If you want to have observers, you use observers light. That means observers is the ability to call functions if there are changes in the values of the property. Of course, yung object accessors, you also put it here. And array accessors if you want to have object and array manipulations and then automatically calling changes on the properties. And of course, if you want to use template light, you can just course it through here and then you'll have element light. So I'll be giving yung link nito on the video itself. I'll be creating another one siguro, or a silent creation na lang siguro, while working on this project, so that you can see my thought process. But yeah, this is how the project works. Yeah, thanks for listening.